48 hours after the bloody war began between Israel and Palestine, after the Hamas fighters fired more than 5,000 rockets within no time, Israel said it had retaken full control of Gaza. The IDF has ordered a full siege of Gaza and gathered 300,000 troops ahead of what many expect to be a ground operation. We can't deny that there are terrorists still inside Israel, Israel Defense Forces spokesman Richard Hedge said. There are still small pockets of exchange, but in general, right now, we have more or less gained control of the communities. Defense Minister Yoav Gallant has ordered a full siege of the blockaded Gaza Strip. No power, no food, no gas. Everything is closed. We are fighting human animals and we act accordingly, said Gallant, a former IDF commander who now serves in Benjamin Netanyahu's hardline nationalist government. Israel has been launching a barrage of retaliatory airstrikes against Gaza, with the death toll on both sides climbing. At least 700 people in Israel are reported to have been killed. Another 560 people have been killed in Gaza in retaliatory Israeli strikes. Palestinian militant group Hamas has threatened to execute hostages if Israeli airstrikes continue in Gaza. The group has reportedly dragged off about 150 people in its surprise weekend assault on Israel. Israel has not yet said exactly how many people were taken by Hamas, but the Israeli embassy to the US said early Sunday that dozens had been kidnapped. Israeli warplanes pounded downtown Gaza City, home to Hamas's center of government, with relentless bombardments into early Tuesday after Israel's prime minister vowed retaliation against the Islamic militant group that would reverberate for generations. Israeli tanks and drones were deployed to guard breaches in the Gaza border fence to prevent new incursions. Thousands of Israelis were evacuated from more than a dozen towns near Gaza, and the military summoned 300,000 reservists, a massive mobilization in a short time. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken reaffirmed efforts to secure the immediate release of all hostages taken by Hamas amid war with Israel. I spoke with Israeli Foreign Minister Eli Cohen about how the U.S. is supporting Israel as it defends itself against Hamas terrorist attack and reaffirmed efforts to secure the immediate release of all hostages, he tweeted. The moves, along with Israel's former declaration of war on Sunday, pointed to Israel increasingly shifting to the offensive against Hamas, threatening greater destruction in the densely populated, impoverished Gaza Strip. As the Israeli military brought additional forces near the border, a major question was whether it would launch a ground assault into the tiny Mediterranean coastal territory. The last ground assault was in 2014.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.